Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about rate and level of absorption and how rate and level of absorption matters. So let's talk about absorption coefficient. We've heard that term many, many times. And what is that? Well, that's just the ability of the sample size in the test, and let's call it 1 square foot. When you hit it with energy, and then you measure the energy on the other side and then the reflected energy off of it, you'll see that at certain frequencies, it absorbs X. Now that's on that sample size. So you have to make interpolations about, well, how is 50% on a surface area going to sound? How is 60% on a surface area going to sound? So you have to figure all that out. And rate and level of absorption is so important in our music rooms because we're dealing with the time signature of really critical reflections. So we want to make sure that we're slowing these things down at the right level and rates. Level is critical because we want to, you know, make sure we get the lowest frequency that we can within the design parameters of our product. In this case, let's just use 2-inch foam. So we want to make sure we get the lowest frequency we can, but more importantly, the rate. So if our low frequency is 125, how do we do up to 6,000? You know, what are we like this or are we like this? You know, so the goal is to have it as smooth as possible so it's predictable and consistent along that line somewhere. And these time signatures in this sidewall reflections are so critical. So you really have to have, you know, the proper rate and the proper level to look at. Roxel, DuPont 703, 702 and all those. Those are building insulation, not designed with a rate and level that's conducive for music and voice. Just remember that. Yes, they absorb, but rate and level does matter. So you have to make that into consideration. So pick a product that has the rate and level designed for voice and music. If you don't know what that is, we'll talk about that on another video. So foam is open-celled. Everybody kind of knows that. Why? Uniformity and its consistent depth and then a consistent structure throughout the whole thing. So that's the goal. The cool thing about our foam, the way it's designed, it's like a beehive. The sides of the cells that are open are all, it's a hexagon. So you have nice balance in there and then they're consistent. You know, they interact with each other better than I can draw. So there you go. So rate and level when you're choosing sound absorption materials. And you must look at that rate and level, and you must look at the amount you're absorbing, how low you're going, and how fast you're going. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.